Hello, I've been looking for the simple, basic, fundamental keys of what it is that makes things go so horribly, badly wrong for everybody as soon as we get saved. And you've heard me speak about the fact that there's three sorts of Christian, narrow wayers and broad roaders in the Ecclesia, the called out ones, those who to whom the Lord Jesus has spoken, and the vast majority type 3 Christians, brought up, taught, sign up and coerced Christians. You've heard me say there's a huge difference between them, and they see things from a completely different perspective, and stuff that leaves you and I utterly exasperated, where you can speak the truth of God and it goes right past their ears like it was some kind of, you know, discussion about Mickey Mouse or something. So you've heard me speak about these things in the past, but there's another key that all God has allowed me to find recently. And yesterday, the day before, it was speaking to me very strongly about, except the Lord build the house, they labour in vain that build it. Now, we know one of the reasons why people are so strong about church is quite simply they are... it's their protection from God. They're building their golden calf. They're building their Tower of Babel up to God. They are going to approve themselves before him their way without his sovereign action. But you know that the grace of a father will not allow that. The Lord God of Israel won't allow people to justify themselves before God. He has said, all your righteousnesses are as filthy rags. The things you do to approve yourself before God, whether it's hideous pagan rites like Roman Catholicism or Anglicanism, where you've got all these rites and ceremonies and prancing about in frocks and waving fiery handbags and all the rest of it. Well, you know, this is just, you know, it's just nuts, isn't it? But whether you're doing this kind of stuff, or whether you're out there doing good works to make sure men see you do it, or whether you're going to church and doing a lot of church, you know, oh, we're active in the church. And how many have we all, haven't we all heard that many, many times in the past? However, these things have been going on all around us, but one thing that stuck in me very clearly was not so much people are building themselves up to God, but the fact that they are simply building. Now, you see the problem with this in the book of, say, the Galatians got their ears burned for this severely, didn't they? They got their ears really, really torn off the side of their head for this by Paul. You read that book of Galatians carefully. They began in the spirit and now they're doing church. They're doing religion. They're observing times and seasons, days and years. They're doing all kinds of religious stuff to commend themselves before God, when actually they were already in the spirit. Having begun in the spirit, you now made perfect by the flesh. Whatever is in the power of the flesh, natural born man, to do, church, go along, get your sermon sandwich, sing your hymns, listen to a lecture by some qualified person at the front, not that there is a front, actually amongst God's people, and then do a bit more singing, perhaps a little bit of praying, have a swift cup of coffee, and you've gone home again, making yourself feel like you, which makes you feel like you're righteous. When you're doing this kind of stuff, whatever kind of thing it is that you are hoping to commend yourself to God with, you don't stand a monkey's chance. If you have started taking control of the work of the Lord God of Israel, and you started doing it yourself, you have immediately cancelled out your blessing and everything. Paul talks about coming into, you know, being in bondage. You know, if you take off into Babylon and you become into more bondage, your state is worse in the bondage of Babylon than it was when you were in the bondage to the world and to sin. Worse. Quite simply because You know, it's, you've cut yourself off from the blessing of God. The Lord cannot bless us if we are seen to be working to earn his approval. This is the grace of the Father that we're talking about. We just receive. And like a branch in the vine, John 15, the sap of the true vine flows through us and we partake of it, and out through us to those who are around us. In generally speaking, that's just to the saved, to God's children. But if you're doing anything whatsoever that's going to try, that's an effort to curry favour with God, you have just shot yourself in the foot and cancelled your blessings. You have. He cannot bless you because it would be seen that you earned it. Now, this idea that we earn it is very deeply ingrained in human beings. Very deeply ingrained. You do well, you're rewarded. You don't do well, you get, you know, left out, whatever, punished possibly. Now, that's not like that in the new covenant at all. I'll be merciful to whom I will be merciful, and have compassion on whom I will have compassion. However, let's just think about that word build for a moment. I will build my ecclesia, unless I know the word there. The translation in English is normally their church, but that's, I'll come to that in a moment. And the counsels of death shall not prevail against her. The text there does not say it. It doesn't say the gates of hell. It says the councils of death. Now, you know, the elders of the city would have sat just inside the main gate and to have a council on this business and that business and all the rest of it. That's why, you know, you had those things, the gates of hell shall not prevail. The councils of death, it should read, and shall not prevail against her, the ecclesia, her, the bride of Christ. Her, not it. I will build my ecclesia, not church. Church is a word, is a corruption of Circe, a Greek goddess's name, and it is entirely men's building, whereas the ecclesia is entirely the Lord God's building. I will build it. But just that word build, think about this. Everywhere they are building. The first thing they want to do when there's a move of God is have their own building, or put a building up, or put up, erect a nice new shiny building at huge expense. We got our own building and stuff, and it's called so-and-so church. As soon as you put that building up, you are in trouble. You've established an institution, you've built something. But nevertheless, and that's where it starts, straight away, the moment you start building, it's all over. That's it. And this is one of those keys. I knew that things go wrong right in the beginning of a work of God. Things go horribly wrong. Why? Because men seize charge, Galatians. They start simply being recipients of the grace of God, they take over and they start doing it unto the Lord as though it lies in their power to fix these things. It doesn't at all. But that word build, notice, yes, we understand that they're building their way up to God. They're building their way up to the Tower of Babel. You know, they're trying to build themselves up to God, approve themselves before the Lord. And we understand that they'll set up golden calves, given half a chance. But it's the unregenerate man that does that. The disciple doesn't do it unless they depart from the Lord. And if you depart from the Lord, well, look out you. You know, that's a serious issue. But what is this another thing, another key here? What are they doing? They are building their own head. What they erect is another head. They build this thing because this head, this new head, will tell them what they want to hear. They don't want to hear what the Lord Jesus has to say. What they're doing is they are building another head, and they will set themselves up at the front and in this sermon sandwich on Sunday affair church, even if they've got some right words and they now call it a fellowship rather than the church. And even if they've got, they allow open worship and all. Functioning of the gifts of the Spirit. Oh my God. They're going to let people prophesy and pray in the gathering. But notice Pasty is still at the front, or worse, Pasty and Mrs. Pasty, or even Pasty S. Oh, it's horrendous. But nevertheless, what they're building is another head, a comfort zone, a yes to approve themselves before the Lord. But why are they doing it? It's so they can keep themselves away from God and hear what, via the Bible even, oh my goodness, via some nice pastor. They can hear what they want to hear. I've had men who are pastors tell me in the past that, oh, you can't talk about this or you can't talk about that. You'll upset people and there'll be problems and all the rest of it. I am terribly sorry. You have no right to vary the will and truth of God. None at all. He is Lord. You are a mere wretched human being. Don't you dare start saying what's right and what's not right, what should be taught and what not should or should not be taught. It's utter, total wickedness, isn't it? So let's just think about that. Let's just think about that. Don't build. No building. Building is banned completely. The Lord moves or the Lord does not move. We are a body and we move. We meet from house to house. We're out and about in society, if you like. We're around. We meet each other. We fellowship. You could be stood in a small huddle in the street. You could be anywhere, really. Does everybody have to be there at the same time? No, not necessarily. You can have, groups over there and one side of town and another group's meeting over here and all these kinds of things. Then you come together for fellowship. But that came to me very, very strongly. Except the Lord build the house, they labour in vain that build it. And I'm thinking of a particular fellowship is as dead as doornails, no better than a bunch of Anglicans or Methodists today. That started with a genuine move of God many years ago. And this particular fellowship is now a sterile load of old church in the Pentecostal flavour. But these days, but 50, 60 years ago, the Lord God was moving there in power. What happened? The man who started it did up a stone-built barn place that was out the back of this building, did it up, and started a church. Over the door of this entranceway, he put the words Full Gospel Church in a sign. Full Gospel Church. And people transferred their loyalty from Jesus Christ to their church. And even though they know it's as dead as a doornail, there are still one or two people there from many years ago who are clinging on to this thing, and they're very old now, of course, but nevertheless, clinging on to this because this is my church. And I want to have my funeral here. Indeed, we were at the funeral of someone a while ago who was been there for donkey's years. And unfortunately, do I think she made it? No. No, I think she took the Galatians road and she was Broad Road. And she was doing all kinds of things to ingratiate herself with God. And we don't do that, of course. We're just receivers. We don't bother to ingratiate ourselves. The work is done. We've been baptized into Christ. I mean, the good of what he's done. That's the end of that. Beware the builders. Beware builders. They aren't trustworthy. Anyone who wants to build or work for the Lord, who had this great experience of God, let's go and build something. Don't even think about it. Just simply abide in the vine, do as you are given to do, and get on with your life of him expressing himself through you as and when or if he wishes. And if he doesn't, there's nothing we can do about that. It's nothing to do with you and me. But the builders are building themselves another head. This is the strength of why they are so determined on their church. It isn't just that it's their Tower of Babel up to God, which of course it is in many cases. It's because they've built this thing, which is their alternative head, which tells them what they want to hear. They don't want to hear about God and what he requires of them. It's an alternative head. Jesus Christ is our head. And this, whatever you build, which is an alternative head, which will tell you what you want to hear, is rendered what in Scripture? Antichrist. Jesus Christ is the head of the body. Antichrist means false or alternative anointed one. Okay. And if you've gone and built church, it has a power, that spirit of Antichrist, the spirit of the church person, the spirit of Antichrist is there immediately. And that whole thing completely negates the work of God. He stops as soon as you take charge, as soon as you take over and you stop taking your orders, stop taking instruction, you stop taking his leading, he takes a step back. No one notices. Then he leaves. And there you are with another load of old church and another pastor disaster is born.